Well, it seems we are a long way from hooked on phonics. However, can we really blame this teacher for simply being honest? Let's talk on the mic. Hello, hello, good people. This is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker, coming back at you live once again from the Lone Star State with another edition of the Media Mike Speaks. All right, good people, it is 10 minutes past the hour, and yes, we are the voice of the everyday citizen. It is a chilling 42 degrees here in the Metroplex, the Lone Star State, and one of my subscribers sent me this story. Well, good people, in our own backyard, well, this is Texas. Hey, as you saw in the title, Texas teacher fired for telling students his race is superior. And we all know most likely what race of teacher that was. So, let's get to the story, shall we? A Texas teacher has been placed on leave after a shocking video emerged of him saying he believes white people are the superior race. You know, he may need to see that video on Jimmy the Greek. Look that up, good people. And I elaborate on that later on. Now, in the video, the unidentified white teacher in the Pflugerville Independent School District was captured saying, deep down in my heart, he quotes, I'm ethnocentric, which means I think my race is the superior one, unquote. It's unclear what led to the controversial conversation inside a classroom at Bohls Middle School. Now, the video obtained by KVUE shows the student's quick reaction to the statement, which prompted one student to ask, so white is better than all? Well, it seems a lot of people with their pigmentation seem to think so. The teacher, The teacher then asked the students to let them finish speaking before adding, I think everybody thinks that. They're just not honest about it, unquote. Now, that is a good question. Now, bear in mind that these kids are young, but then again, we don't know if they've been indoctrinated, so I don't know. Now, several students then appeared to confront the teacher about his bold claim, asking him if he just openly admitted to being racist. I think everybody is a racist at that level, the teacher responded. When asked a second time if he just said he is racist, the teacher said, I did, if I'm going to be honest with you, unquote. Yeah, it's being honest. Can't argue with that. Now, he says, no, I'm not going to say it again. I said it enough, the teacher added. Now, he kind of knew then, you know. The teacher, seemingly done with the conversation, can then be heard asking students to put their phones down. Now, I don't know about using these phones in the school systems, good people. I don't know if you are allowed to record. I don't know the public school system's policy in certain districts, but we'll see. Now he goes on to say, he quotes, I respected you for a while, but now I don't have any more respect for you. One student, on this, good people. Let me repeat this again. One student says, it quoted, I respected you for a while, but now I don't have any more respect for you. One student said, prompting another to say that they felt the same. The teacher replied, no, you should have more respect because I'm honest, unquote. That's a good question. That's a good response, That's a good response. No, not at all, another student quickly responded. Well, once again, they're young. They don't get the honesty part yet. Parents of students in the school district said they found the conversation inappropriate and upsetting for their young children. Yeah, I think this teacher... As you can see, you know, based on, you know, his age, it seems to me he probably is a boomer, I would say. Came through a different time period. And that's probably why he felt, so honest to say that. I think the most disturbing piece is that it was a situation where kids had experienced this real time. Dr. Shante Lyons, a parent in the school district, told KVUE. Another parent, Brian Hennington, told the outlet that this kind of conversation should have never taken place in school. Well, I do agree with that. Got a good point. There are other personal experiences we've had as people of color that we had individually, but to see this in the classroom setting is just not acceptable, Hennington said. Now, Pflugerville Independent School District Superintendent Dr. Douglas Killeen released a statement following the incident, saying officials were aware of an inappropriate conversation that took place during an advisory class. This interaction does not align with our core belief as a district. The video of the conversation includes statements that we find wholly inappropriate. The teacher has been placed on administrative leave while Human Resources conducts an investigation, Killeen said. Pflugerville ISD and Bohls work together to create an inclusive and welcoming environment for our students. The advisory activity was inappropriate, inaccurate, and unacceptable. This type of interaction will not be tolerated in Pflugerville schools. Okay, there you have it. So, getting back to that Jiminy Creek thing. You know, Jiminy Creek was dismissed in the 90s for making a somewhat racial comment regarding athletes and slavery, about why they were so superior. Look this up. He was dismissed off of primetime television. He was a sports commentator, and he was subsequently banished to obscurity. Now, was he being honest? You know, he went on to say some things regarding African Americans. No, not bad, mind you, but saying that we can't let them take control, because if we did, I'm paraphrasing now, but he says, because he was asked, well, why not? He says, because they have everything. They're better at everything. This is his quotes, I'm paraphrasing. You can look this up, Jiminy Creek. He said, they have everything. They're better at everything. So, I don't know, you tell me. Is it about time we have an honest conversation about race? Now, see, those kids are young. Those are probably way beyond Z's, and they're probably Generation E's, and, you know, I don't know. But it's something I think needs to actually be talked about. Now, I don't think, you know, that was appropriate. I mean, this man obviously looks to be somewhere, maybe 60s, I don't know. But if he is, that's, you're talking a baby boomer. So they experience a lot of things, and they just tend to speak their mind. And he should have known better not to even say that. That's not the place to say it. These are young, impressionable minds. They don't even get it yet. They kind of, sort of, but no, they ain't begin to live yet in this world we have today. So which really hasn't changed much. And I think we have to have an honest conversation about history. That's where it starts. Because it's funny how when people talk about race, they don't include history. I mean, real history. Accurate history. And that's what needs to be taught. What I find very interesting is that, especially among a lot of African Americans, is that, you know, you don't really see a lot of them in anthropology, archaeology, history, from that matter. You know, we don't need other races of individuals telling another race of individuals about their history. So, what do you think, good people? Should he get his job back? No, I think not. No, man. Come on now. Really? And here's the thing, who taught you that? I wonder who taught him that. And to be a teacher, he should go and really do his own history. You see? Because it seems to me he's lacking a lot of respect. Because if you really do your history and your homework, you'll find that all races contributed to the world, not just America, the world. But the problem is, when you have a certain group of individuals, a certain race of people who suppress all of those accomplishments, then that's when you get down to the nitty-gritty. So, to me, you then become inferior. Until next time, it's your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night.
I'll understand you soon, it won't be long. Keep on, keep running.